Hey everyone, it's Frank here, and you can see it's time for another Oh My God big surprise, just like last time, SH Monster Arts Mechagodzilla. So, yeah, after the first SH review, you know, the Godzilla I did, a lot of people kind of didn't like it, kind of liked it, and they were, you know, it was kind of a crazy video, so let's try not to repeat that here. I do have a lot I wanted to say about this figure, so let's get to it. Here's the box. It's a box, it's pretty neat, so yeah. I do like the boxes, though. They look cool. So, SH Monster Arts Mechagodzilla. Wow, this is quite a nice figure, actually. Let me adjust the focus here. There we go, that's much better. This figure released, you know, sometime a little after Godzilla. He stands about, just under 7 inches, you know, at his tallest. So he's a pretty decently sized figure. You know, he's in scale with the Godzilla, of course. So, they look good together. No complaints there. Yeah, make a nice battle scene. Or something, I don't know. So yeah, they look good together. That's kind of the important thing. Let's just get him out of here. Now, this is obviously, you know, probably one of the least popular Mechagodzilla out there. You know, a lot of people like Kiryu. Oh my God, so awesome. A lot of people like the original Mechagodzilla. Oh, it's a classic, blah, blah, blah. I personally like this one the best. The reason is because I grew up with this Mechagodzilla, you know? I was first introduced to the real Godzilla series and their actual monsters through the video game Godzilla Destroy All Monsters Melee for the GameCube. It was one of my earliest, you know, exposures besides just, you know, the American Godzilla film and just the Godzilla Power Hour. This is my real exposure to the actual, you know, kaiju. And Mechagodzilla was the final boss at the end of the story mode. I always remember him being such a tough, you know, tough enemy. He was always just really hard to beat. And when I finally locked him, it was so awesome to play as him. And ever since then, I've been growing up with this Mechagodzilla mostly. So, it wasn't until much later I, you know, got, you know, into the other Mechagodzillas and learned about Kiryu and stuff. So really, this Mechagodzilla has been, you know, one of the, you know, earliest memories I have. And, you know, in fact, the Bandai Mechagodzilla was the very first, you know, Godzilla figure I ever owned, like, period. So, the figure and the monster kind of have a special place in my heart, you know? So yeah, speaking of which, here he is compared to the Bandai figure. We've had this one for a while now, you know, this just the common 6-inch figure. And yeah, they just stacking them together, and obviously it's, you know, a completely new figure, you know, things have changed, a little more different, a little more accurate. You know, but I still like this figure just for, you know, being Mechagodzilla. And one thing this does have over the new one is the eyes. Instead of, you know, they're not clear, obviously, or whatever, but they're yellow and they actually look correct. This one, this is one of my few complaints. The eyes are translucent, yes, and they're nicely detailed, but you could, unless they're in light, you could really can't see them. So they just look black most of the time. I don't know, it's really annoying. That's kind of unfortunate that they would do that. I mean, why make it orange? Why not make it, you know, yellow? I mean, I understand why they made it orange, because that's the way it was on the movie prop, but, you know, the movie prop could glow, so herkader, dumb idea. And just for fun, here he is compared to the Bandai Creation Mechagodzilla as well. As you can see, his arms are pretty elongated when compared to this one, especially, you know, in comparison to this guy. And they're pretty much the same size, but obviously, you know, completely different figure. But, yeah, this is just for fun, because I do like the Heisei Mechagodzilla, so a lot of people who are like, oh, I don't like this Mechagodzilla, I'm like, whatever, I dig it. And lastly, for fun, here is he, you know, compared to the Jigoken Showa Mechagodzilla, because we never got a Jigoken, you know, Heisei Mechagodzilla. We did get the DX Kings and King Scale Mechagodzillas, but those are, you know, a little hard to come by, and they're much pricier. But they are pretty neat, and of course there is a Trendmasters 10-inch light and sound Mechagodzilla that is basically the King Scale figure, just 10 inches and kind of less good, but whatever. So there's definitely some, you know, good choices out there for this guy, and I appreciate it. You know, he wouldn't be my first choice, you know, considering all the other monsters that are, you know, released out there, but, you know, I like him, and I just wanted to get it and try it out, so yeah. Overall, I'm really happy with this guy, but we'll get more into that in a second. Now, Mechagodzilla here, Peach is a pretty simple paint job, because he's just really just silver, and, you know, some black in between, you know, like the ankles, or knees, arms, whatever. Pretty simple stuff. And he does look good. I mean, he shines pretty well. I mean, sometimes in the wrong light, he can just look be like he's plain, flat, white color, but, you know, it's definitely a light shade of silver. So he does look pretty good. Like this one, for example, it looks really, like, metally and metallic-y, but it kind of has a hue to it that looks at, it makes it look a little too, dirty. And so, yeah, it's whatever you're really into, but I personally do like the paint job on this guy. He looks good, so nothing to complain about there. The eyes, I already talked about, not too happy about the eyes. They could have been done better, but what are you going to do? Now, articulation of this guy. The Mechagodzilla is actually way more poseable than the Godzilla, probably the most poseable of all the figures we've seen released yet. His arms, you know, they swivel around like this and rotate pretty easy. And the elbows, they don't, you know, he doesn't have a bicep joint like Godzilla does, you know. Like, just for example, he can't do that, you know. I guess maybe a design flaw, they just thought of like, oh, we'll just leave it, whatever. So he can't do that. His arms can go out a little, just like that, but it's not that much. Like Godzilla, he does have, you know, double joints, which is actually a really clever way of, you know, doing them. Like I said, if you look closely, you can see the joint and how it kind of bends. It allows them to bend the limbs at a much, you know, greater degree than normally. And it actually hides, you know, the joints as well. So, yeah, it just looks natural and smooth. Pretty clever. The hands are kind of on a little peg. It really depends on what you do with it. In some cases here, see, I can move it like this. But then if I twist it, I may be able to move like this. So the peg is a little weird, but whatever. Basically, you can twist it, and that's all you really need for it. So, yeah, you can get them in a decent amount of poses. Torso, obviously, it can move. I mean, it can move more than this, but I really just don't feel like moving it too much, because, you know, what do you really need that for? It can move up and down just a little bit. Yeah, that's about as much as you can go. Let's see, the head, what I don't like about the head is they actually made the head a separate joint, and it can actually swivel a little bit, you know, like this, but I don't like it because they made it loose to the point where he really bobbles his head a lot. You see? It's too loose, and it should just be, you know, really stiff, but maybe it's just my figure. I don't know. Get his hands out the way. Okay. So his head rotates, obviously, you know, like in the movie, and also like in the movie, he can't look up and down, you know? It's just that. And that is, you know, while it's accurate to the movie, and I understand why they did it, it is kind of annoying because you have to swap out his head for a different piece. You know, if you want to go into flying mode, which is, you know, another thing I'm not too happy about. But, yeah. He also moves his jaw, as you can see. Pretty cool. You know, what else? You know, obviously he's got to move the jaw. Tail does not move. Yeah. Back has a separate piece here for, you know, docking with Garuda, but obviously I don't have Garuda, even though he should have came in the package. But what can you do? I guess if I really want Super Mechagodzilla, I gotta pay an extra $50 to $100. Thank you, Tamashii Nations. You don't include him with the right accessories, you know. I mean, come on. Not including him with Garuda. That's like not including Godzilla, you know, with the Heat Ray, which they already did. So yeah, I guess I shouldn't be surprised. You know, what's next? Gonna release King Ghidorah without a middle head? Oh, you want the real King Ghidorah and you gotta pay an extra $50, please? Yeah. Don't worry, they're not doing that. Don't take my word as gospel or anything like that. This is where people pay attention. It's sarcasm. Anywho, the legs. The legs are pretty good. They can, you know, obviously just move out and, you know, like this and twist. And they're actually designed to have a joint that kind of pops in and out, like, see, like this? To allow some slightly more, you know, better poseability. And you can obviously just pop it in anytime you want. The knees are pretty clever. They're double joint as well, but they can also pop out, you know, like this. And then just pop back in. So yeah, he can bend them in a pretty good degree. And with this, you know, this joint here, you can get some really good action out of him. Very poseable, very flexible, very cool. This here is just a swiveling joint for that feet, you know, the feet. It moves up like this so you can get him on his toes, but of course this part here kind of, yeah, I don't know. I think they could have done that better. But his feet do that. And they're on a small ball joint. They kind of swivel and turn as well, but not too much. Same for this joint. Though this one comes out a little easy on mine. I don't know. So whatever. The feet, you know, they do that pretty good. So yeah, you can get some decent posability out of him. He's a little hard to balance though because, oops. Yeah. He does. The figure does have die-cast in the feet and a few other parts as well to kind of help weigh him down, make him easier to pose, and he can also rest on his tail pretty easily. But yeah, not it. He's got enough die-cast to work. I know some people, you know, they're like, "Oh, why is this figure so much expensive than Godzilla?" Well, that's because the die-cast, really. And I guess the die-cast drives the price, you know, pretty good. He tends to go about maybe $10-$20 more than Godzilla does. And he's definitely a little hefty, but he doesn't have anywhere near as much diecast as the Jigoku figures, which according to some people, they really don't have that much more diecast, which they do, so get over it, it's a fact. I don't want to, you know, start another argument here, but, you know, touch it feels like diecast, looks like diecast, and it feels like diecast, looks like diecast, and it's probably diecast, so get over it. You're wrong, sorry. So whatever, not important. He's got enough, you know, he's very sturdy. He's not going to fall apart on you anytime soon, not like Godzilla, where the head just, you know, head just kind of, oops, you know, so easy. So, yeah, we're not going to have any of that here. That's kind of the important thing. He does have a lot of swappable parts, but they're not, you know, loose or anything like that, so that's really cool. You know, you don't even have to worry about him falling apart while you're trying to pose him or anything like that. So that's, you know, that's definitely a plus. So yeah, we went over haven't gotten over the detail yet, so let's get to it. So Mechagodzilla really doesn't have much going for him in terms of detail, but that's because, you know, as a result of the character, not just the figure. But he does look pretty good. I mean, you got all the details there, the exhaust ports, the little panels, the hands. Very nice looking. You know, it's all there. And yeah, I mean, can't ask for much better than this. And look at that. That's really nice. Let's get a better look at the eyes. There you go. Oop. Alright, there you go. Now you can see them. Kind of a translucent deal going on. Unfortunately, that's kind of the problem. You know, they're just dark most of the time. So yeah, all the details are here, and he looks fantastic. So yeah, Salt Monster, it's Mechagodzilla. Pretty good. Okay, maybe not pretty good, that was my fault, sorry. This figure does not have a problem with, you know, balance. You just gotta get used to how you have to pose him. You know, like, usually I do like this, and there you go. Now he's standing up straight. Before, I really didn't know how I could get him to stand, you know, without having a rest on the tail, but now I got it pretty good. So, don't let that throw you off. If you're like, oh, he keeps falling over, or I can't get him to stand without resting on the tail, just do like this, and you should be good. But he do have enough weight, like I said, thanks to the diecast, so he can stand pretty good. Yeah. That was a little embarrassing. Okay, so what do we gotta do next? Well, it's our favorite part, accessories. Well, here we are, we got all the accessories out, and I suppose let's get to it. Hopefully this won't be as bad as Godzilla. He does have a lot more accessories, but we'll see. We'll save the best for last. First of all, these hands. He comes with two spare hands that he can plug into little pegs on his wrists, and yeah. They're just pointy hands. Well, yeah, these are other fucking shit. I'm sorry. I don't know. I don't really like doing this because I'm afraid the pegs will fall out or whatever. You just pull it. You know, that seems to be a theme with this line. Just pull it and it'll come out. Don't, you know, nothing to lock it in. No, you just pull and pray. That's really it. So, yeah. Okay, there, we got the hand in. Looking great already. Take this, come on. I'm always afraid it's gonna break, and I swear to God, I'm never gonna do this, you know, after this review. See, look at that, it's already, come on. Come on. Swear to God, just, there you go. And so yeah, now you got pointy fingers for whatever fucking reason you want. I mean, I'm not sure why you would ever want these ugly hands on him. Now, technically these are for flying mode, but really, is there that much of a difference between, you know, that and this, that you want to have an extra set of hands? I don't know. We'll leave them in for now, though. They look really stupid, I think. I mean, just look at them. Really not interesting at all. Just, you know, I would have rather referred fist, you know? He really didn't punch anything, but that would have been more interesting, at least. Better looking aesthetic, you know, a design change than just, ooh, he's got straight fingers because, fuck it. We can't think of anything else. As you can see, he already has the plasma grenade launcher in. I actually keep it in because I think it looks better, and because that's the way it was on his video game model in Destroy All Monsters, you know, the game that introduced me to this character and Godzilla as a whole, really. So I just kind of leave it in for nostalgia reasons, but for this review, we'll take it out. And yeah, you just pull it and hope for the best. Yeah, he does have, you know, swappable parts, that's cool, but this is kind of, annoying. So yeah, we'll take in the regular plasma grenade part and just kind of stick it back on. And there you go, that's how most people have it, obviously, but I'm not like most people, so yeah. So yeah, there is, you know, regular Mechagodzilla, so we'll just keep it in for now. We'll just kind of straighten these out so I can show off flying mode. Yeah, not too too interesting. Now again, for the head, you gotta pull it out, you hope for the best. Pull this out, hope for the best. Insert this new part, stick it in, and insert Mechagodzilla's head on the peg. And there he is in flying mode. Well, at least with the head, the flying mode head. And lastly, you need to take the tail, pull it off, hope for the best, and stick this one. It's on this little peg, as you can see. A slightly straighter tail, as in very slightly, and just, God. Come on, there you go. Adjust the legs, like so. Thank you, Monstarts. I'm glad I paid $60 for this toy that will not operate right. So yeah, you can kind of see where I'm getting at when I say quality control and $60 not worth it. So we've got some people try to justify this crap, and you know, you're seeing it firsthand. And I'm not the first. I said, you know, heard someone else say, yeah, mine has loose foot as well. Pretty annoying. Okay, let's just hope it sits in this time. I'm not sure if it will, but whatever. Okay, so just the hands again. Just the back. And there you go. There's flying mode. Pretty nifty. Don't care for all the part swapping, though. I mean, they could have just made the head swivel up and down and problem solved. The tail, I mean, really, is that much, you know, too big of a deal? I really don't care. Whatever, I'm probably not going to use this, you know, these parts very much. You know, I'm too afraid they'll break. So, whatever. Take the tail back out. Regular good tail back in. Take these stupid hands out. Put the good hands back in. Hopefully they'll stay in. You know, I won't have to do this again, I hope. There you go. That's regular old hands, and now the head. Pull it out, hope for the best. Seems to be a running theme here. And there you go. Mechagodzilla back to regular self. Well, except for the torso, I might as well get that now. Yeah, whatever. So yeah, a lot of part swapping, as you can see, a lot of pulling and praying and hoping nothing breaks. But I suppose that's better than just, you know, nothing at all, you know? At least you have the option, if you really want to. So yeah, there's all the part swapping stuff done. The hands, again, they suck. They're pretty useless, just, you know, the flying mode parts, you know, excluding the hands. Tail, kind of eh. You know, it's barely different. The headpiece, well, yeah, I guess that they had to, since they weren't going to make the head swivel up and down, so whatever. But the only real good one, I think, is the plasma grenade launcher, and of course, I already have mine in. So yeah, I think it's a cool addition. It gets a thumbs up from me. And now, the most dreaded one of all, the heat accessory, or the heat beam accessory, the breath weapon, whatever. So you guys remember what happened last time, right?
He's like vomiting water.
It's a circle, and this is like, you know, not a circle.
Yeah, I hate these fucking accessories.
Right. Okay, so, is it going to be a repeat performance? Let's see. First of all, the stand. It's a green turd, and, it's a green turd, yeah. Best way I can describe it, a green turd. Obviously, it's supposed to be a mountain hillside, you know, and it's green because, I don't know, grass, whatever. But whatever, it looks like a green turd. But this green turd is actually a better, you know, choice than the atomic effects parts Godzilla had, because this is actually pretty sturdy. I mean, it has enough weight to it and enough, you know, I don't know, ground it covers that it really holds up the accessory well. It does not flop over or anything, because in Godzilla's case, the beam accessory was heavier than the effect, you know, the radiation part base. So it was kind of floppy. This one, not so much. Very sturdy, probably because this one is so, you know, thin and small now. But sorry about that. The camera was low on space and I had to empty the card. But, okay, we're back. Where was I? I think I was talking about this. Yeah. It's lightweight and it's small, so it can be held up by this really well. And this one, it's sturdy, you know, despite being a green turd, bleh, it can hold up this pretty well. That's really not, you know, not the fault of the figure or, you know, the Godzilla. But, you know, whatever. It works better. That's the point. So the stand, the arm, here we go. Will it work? Circle shape, not a circle shape. Oh my god. Oh my god, it fucking fits. Holy shit, look at that. It fucking fits and it's not floppy. It's holding in. Oh my god. It's like, oh shit. This is fucking sweet. Yeah, apparently in between the time they released Godzilla and Mechagodzilla, they decided, hey, let's make this not suck. So yeah, bend this forward, bend this backward, bend this up, a little more than that, and it's holding in, oh my god, get the peg hole. Where is the peg hole? Is that it? No. Okay, because of all these multicolors, it's a little harder to find the peg hole. Just give me a sec. Here we go. Got it. Stick it in. Come on. That's the peg hole. Yeah, it's a little stiffer than before. Okay, you can turn. There you go. And look at that, it's holding just fine. Yeah, it's a little wobbly, sure, but it's much better than Godzilla. And it doesn't frickin' fall apart. You can barely touch it. So that is awesome. We need to see more of that. So let's adjust it. And before anyone notes, you know, I'm sure everyone knows this by now, but you're not supposed to stick the beam inside Mechagodzilla's mouth. Yeah, it would have been nice if they had some kind of warning, because a lot of people found out the hard way, and they shoved it into the point where the teeth on the Mechagodzilla actually broke off. So, don't do that. I mean, to be fair, it does kind of show in the box here how it should be done. But, you know, it's an honest mistake when you figure, oh, it's supposed to go in the mouth opens, and there are the Mega Buster, you know, launchers in the mouth, so, durr. So yeah, just don't do that. Now let's adjust to fit in his mouth. Like so, and there you go. There's the Mega Buster. It looks fantastic. It's got a nice pulsing look to it. The base, while being a green turd, is sturdy and it's not flimsy at all. So this beam accessory is good. How about that? Huh. Now, unfortunately, the only real downside to this is that unlike the Godzilla beam accessory, it is all, you know, it's not quite as, you know, thick. You know, it's very small and, you know, it's a little more bendable and, you know, subject, you know, to being warped. You know, basically means that it could be, you know, moved, you know, even while in the box. So this one kind of has a slight curve to it, but it's not a big deal for me. It looks fine in either way. And, yeah, it's just too bad he didn't come with, like, you know, what you call it, plasma grenade accessory. But I suppose you can always substitute this because it kind of fits in the hole just fine. But looks weird. So whatever. Okay, Mechagodzilla. Well, actually, that's all the accessories now. How about that? So yeah, we got all the accessories out the way. You know, the beam accessory isn't too bad. That better than Godzilla's, big improvement. And I already talked about the other accessories. So yeah, that's the review. SH Monster Arts Mechagodzilla. Now, like before, I talked about the price. He is a little more costly than Godzilla, I guess because of the diecast and just being a little bigger, but whatever. I'd say you want to stay in the $60 to $70 range for this guy. But of course, if you want Gerudo like me, you're probably going to pay a lot more, like probably enough for a whole nother figure, because they want your money. Well, whatever. I'm happy with Mechagodzilla for now. You know, just the figure, not the Gerudo, which should have came with. But, yeah, that's the review. Articulation and posability, very good. Much better than Godzilla because he's just more posable for whatever reason. You know, despite being very sturdy, stiff in the movie. His paint job is nice. He has a nice shine to it. He looks excellent. Nothing wrong there. He scales up well with the other figures in the line, or at least Godzilla, which is the most important. His accessories aren't fucking shit, you know, besides the hands and really, really besides the hands. And the beam accessory doesn't blow either. It, you know, it's sturdy, it works, and you can pose it. So, yeah. Aside from not coming with Gerudo, there's really nothing wrong with this figure at all. And if you're a fan of the Mechagodzilla, or just, you know, you like the Heisei movies in general, I say get him. He's definitely worth the price, you know, not any more than $70, really, because that's a little too pricey, I think. But, as far as the Monstars go, he's a solid release, and he's really cool. I dig him. So, yeah. I'm sorry if you're expecting another angry review, but I got most of that out when I was reviewing Godzilla. So, sorry. Yeah. So that's the review. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Mechagodzilla is going to get a 5 out of 5 as well, just like Godzilla. He's an excellent figure, nothing wrong with him. And he scales up well with our favorite scaly friend here. And, yeah, that's the review. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I probably won't be doing any more SH Figurage reviews or whatever because I won't be getting any ones in, you know, in the near future. Looking to get another Ultra Actor too, because I haven't really done anything with that line besides Gomera. So, yeah, hope you guys enjoy the review. And I will catch you guys later.